Hey, hey guys, this is Raiko for VGgameplay, and today we are playing F-Zero on the SNES. Or to be more precise, actually, we're playing it on the Wii U Virtual Console. Just gonna go with the Golden Fox. We're gonna jump straight into the Night League. Because I haven't got a save file, we have to do it on beginner. Which is fine by me, because this game is rock solid. Now, I must warn you, I am incredibly rusty. I played this game through to the end on beginner again when it was released on the Wii U Virtual Console. It was going for like 30 pence, I believe. So, it's been a while. And then prior to that, in fact, was when I recorded our last playthrough of F-Zero for VGgameplay. That was about 5 years ago now, I think. At least 5 years ago. And the reason I'm doing it again is just to try and capture the game in a higher quality, because the footage is quite dated. We didn't have the hardware at the time, and obviously download speeds and things like that all came into effect. And so the quality of the videos we were producing and uploading weren't the highest. There's a lot of tearing, there's a lot of blurring, there's a lot of pixelation, so the idea here is to solve all that with a nice, clean, higher resolution playthrough. Way out my way. If you can't already tell, I am scared of backmarkers. Whoa! Enough that it throws me off quite dramatically. The thing with this game is, if you hit anything, you go flying like a ping pong ball. Like a pinball. You just go in all sorts of directions. So, yeah, the last thing you want to do is crash into them. I didn't play this game, I don't think, until after I played Mario Kart. I'm not sure, but I think I played Super Mario Kart first. And I still enjoyed this one, so, you know, it does hold up well. It's more of a purist racing sort of game. Obviously not a sim, but the focus is on driving. Most definitely. The fact that you can shift your weight in the car to help with the steering, it just adds to the challenge. It allows you to focus on just trying to do the perfect lap. Mario Kart's a bit more sort of sluggish, isn't it? And the focus there is taking out your opponents with weapons, so it's quite a different experience. It's definitely a lot of fun if you do like challenging racing games. The controls are definitely a lot more twitchy, so there's plenty of room for error. Now, I was a kid. How old? I must have been about 7 when this game came out. Probably didn't play it until I was about 9 or 10. Nah, a bit younger than that. What am I talking about? Probably played it when I was about 7, I should say. But I was never a big fan of racing games as a kid. You know, I'd grown up with things like Super Hang-On and all the sort of F1 games. And they never made sense in my head, you know. The games are based around keeping the car on the track, and the track just bends left and right. It doesn't feel like you're going anywhere sometimes. And it feels like your car's being pulled around the corner and you just have to adjust the acceleration to make sure you don't go off. Pretty weird, but as a result, I never really got into racing games. Not until these ones came out, the Mode 7 games. Tell a lie, actually. I was kind of into Road Rash. Road Rash has a nice sense of progression, and it's more about sort of dodging the obstacles as they come at you rather than steering around sharp bends, or bends that are meant to be sharp but just go on forever because they can't be rendered properly. Whoa. All going well so far. I remember thinking as a kid that this track was just concrete with orange floats keeping it above water. It's very weird. It wasn't until like F-Zero X came out that I realised these tracks were all meant to be like in the sky. Or at least quite high up. They always look like they're on the ground. Get up, mummy. Final lap. Oh, he kind of shuffled into me, the cheeky sod. Now I've got cars on the backside. Yeah, like I said, I do not get on with these back markers, but it's part of the challenge, I suppose. If they weren't there, you'd just be doing sort of timed laps. They do make the game quite tough. Forgot to use my boost there, but never mind, never mind. Just getting to the end of the track in first place will do me. Seems like I went through a pattern of getting faster and then slower again. Anyway, next track, Sand Ocean. Again, it looks like it's floating on sand, although the sand is going apeshit. It's like going two different directions at the same time. This track reminds me so much of Super Star Wars. I love looking at the backgrounds in these games, even though they're quite distracting. I like the sort of sci-fi sort-ness to them. Everything looks so expansive. Like, you've got those weird buildings in the background. I assume they're buildings. But then there's not a lot else for like miles and miles and miles. I wonder what was going through the developers' heads when they were making these backgrounds. Like, there's a story behind them. Like, what's that shell all about? Get off the mud! Talking too much. Right, I'm gonna have to boost around this guy, aren't I? No, no, no. Best place you want to be overtaken someone. Drifted there. Please guard my way, thank you. Right, I might hold on to this boost for the final lap just in case anything goes wrong. That way I've got a couple of them to use. Oh crap. Oh, you nutcracker. You think they would get out of your way, considering they're about to blow up? You know, just a thought. But instead, they love to drive in front of you. There we go, last lap. Got them. I'm not very good when it comes to sort of slowing down behind back markers. I kind of feel that's gonna impact me too much. It's not something I try to do often, so probably explains why I crash into them a lot. I'm not particularly good at reading where they're gonna go on the track, so anyway, that's another track down. Trying to remember what the next track is. There you go, I got a little better as we went on. Oh crap. This is gonna be embarrassing. Especially if I keep tangling with this guy. And that guy, and that guy. Thank you. Don't know, if you've never played this game and you can't really tell why I'm driving sideways, it's meant to be a windy track as I get smashed out of the way. I'm about to get a boost, so if I have to, I'll use it to get past Pinky. I don't. Throw in the element of wind, along with the element of just smashing and ping-ponging around the track every time you hit someone, like so, and you get a very difficult racing game. It looks like Chewbacca in the mountains. What's he doing? Giant Chewbacca made of rock. And if you get your angle wrong on those boosts, as I miss another one, you can just go flying into the barrier straight away. So you really need to have this car lined up. There's Chewbacca again in the top left, just chilling out. Right, back markers are annoying when they come in. When they come by themselves, it's when they come in pairs that they become a pain in the ass. The barrier. Final lap. Please get out of my way. So, like, he went to take a swipe at me. See that? I very nearly hit the outer barrier there. And we got traffic. And I tried slowing down. And I've hit it again. And again. I'm gonna boost though and hope that the car behind stays. Ah. What a scrappy finish by one. Deary me. That was some bad time for some traffic. That was like four cars in two corners. Still set like my third fastest lap. I guess that's because the opening lap was a nightmare as well. Apologies for the performance on that one, but the windy tracks I've never been good at. Shut up for a minute and enjoy some of the music. This game has awesome music. Oops. Oh, I got overtaken. Never sure how to take that corner. I don't know if the way I take it is fast enough. But it's the only way I know. It's the only way I've ever known. Let's get some health back. Oh, straighten up my car. Oh dear, I've messed up that corner twice now. It is a slightly faster route, but it does require a bit more effort. Oh, I've never overtaken someone through there. I don't know if what I'm doing is brave or stupid, but I've used a boost. Alright, we're going to perfect it this time. We're going to do it right. There we go. And then we're going to mess up the following corner instead. I suppose that gives me some breathing space against that guy who I've also overtaken on the... I guess it's like a chicane. Final lap. Can we do it? Take a small skin off the wall. Bam! Perfect. Just gotta avoid Mr. Splody. Get around the outside of you. Don't mind about skimming these corners. That'll do that. Surely my fastest lap at the end there. And that is the Knight Cup done and dusted. I thought it was going to be more painful than that, so a bit of relief there, actually. The AI is having trouble getting past these backmarkers. Has he given up? No. I think this track looks really good, the backgrounds on this one especially. Don't know what's going on exactly, I don't know if that's a planet in the background. It's a nice colour scheme. I'm about to be overtaken because I cannot get past that backmarker. There we go, we did it. Only took him a lap. Anyway, guys, that's it. That's all five tracks timed. Hopefully I'll see you in the next part. We're going to do the Queen Cup next, and things are only going to go downhill from here.